Hey everyone, welcome to Denver Senpai Channel.
Yo, I'm Sabina.
My name is Alex.
And today we're watching 25th episode of Free Ren, Beyond's Journey's End.
The second round in the dungeon going on, and our heroes, and not only our heroes, keep fighting the clones.
True, and right now Free Ren with a pretty big group of people trying to find a solution how to fight clone of Free Ren, and apparently Fern has an idea.
She knows how to kill Firen, that's what she said.
That's spooky. And I want to remind you that we have a Patreon channel, so if you're interested in early access full uncut reactions, please join us there.
Link in the description. Let's get it started.
Yay!
Somebody is injured.
Wow.
Who is it?
Wow, he's like dying.
Yeah, where is his golem? She left.
Yeah,
and that witch is powerful.
Come on, go!
But
Oh, that's great! Very powerful team they are right now with all this healing stuff and knowledges.
エーデルさんの見立てでは心の働きを精密に模倣しているだけで。これで楽に倒せる手段はなくなったね。一番の問題は、あの複製体とその術者の正体だ。特に複製体特有の弱点は本当にないのかだ。
仮にあの不正体がフリーレンと同じ実力なら、師匠者がいない。Yeah, every spell should have a counter spell。そいつに弱点はないぜ。情報を持っていたわけか。通りでここまで来れたわけだ。それならば初めから俺たちと情報を共有して協力するべきだ。安易に協力できるか。嫌われたものだな。確かに俺はおっさんだが。
He's old? He doesn't look old.
Like for her, he's old.
Okay, got it now.
先遣隊の観測結果によると、シュピーゲルはあの扉の向こう側、本体は攻撃手段を持たない脆弱な魔物だって話だ。
Ooh, so she knows all this information already.
そいつを倒せば複製体は全部消える。本体は扉の向こう側だ。だがあの扉には強力な封印が施されている。 命がけで宝物庫の扉を閉じる魔法。あの扉は術者が死ぬまで開くことはない。倒すなら急いだ方がいいぜ。どういうことだ？シュピーゲルはダンジョンの中にいるやつ全員の複製体を作り出す。
Yeah, we didn't see a lot of replicas yet.
前回の先遣隊は兄貴の部隊を除いてほとんどが壊滅した。最深部目前のちょうどこの場所でだ。
Dangerous.
複製体は心の働きを精密に模倣しているんですよね。なら行動パターンによる弱点は本人と同じなんですよね。
Yeah, Fern should know a lot about Firen's weak points.
その弱点って何なの？フリーレン様、あっちの壁際に立ってもらってもいいですか？うん。Interesting.
Okay.
気がつきましたか?
Tell us.
なんかわかった？わからん。なぜ戦っている時に気がつかなかったんだ。What's going on？魔法を使う瞬間にほんの一瞬だけ魔力探知が途切れている。自覚があるのならなんで言ってくれなかったんですか?
So Fern is not that perfect.
とにかく作戦会議をしますよ。
Of course, we're not gonna hear anything at all.
Yeah, just a weird edit. Those two fighting. Oh my god. Well, apparently they come in with great ideas.
What is that?
Oh my god.
Oh, that's the bust.
He's dead.
Some way.
Oh my god, what sort of alien is this?
Yeah, they used to fight pretty impressive looking monsters before. Finishing blow by the hero.
こうやってダンジョンのボスを倒すためによく話し合ったなって思って。
So those was about the strategy. It's about time.
よし、攻略を開始しようか。
Okay.
私は歴史上で最も多くのダンジョンを攻略したパーティーの魔法使いだよ。
不正体と戦うのはお前たち二人だけで大丈夫なのか。
少人数の方が相手の行動を予測しやすいからね。
それよりも最深部に集まってくる複製体の足止めの方が。
Yes, more than half of them still there.
それじゃあ開けて。
Boss fight.
Yeah.
Really feels like they were very inspired by Dark Souls in this arc.So it's only turn one then. Yeah, they are identical, but Fern can make the difference. I'm wondering about Fern's replica as well. Where is it?
Oh, yeah.
Like, isn't it the most powerful fight in this world?
Two it Ferns. Might be, yeah.Would expect Feren against Feren.
でも目の前の互角の相手の対処で手に入る。ペルを探す余裕なんてあるはずがない。だって私の怖さは私が一番よく分かっている。完璧に潜伏したフェルンは私でもそう簡単に探知できない。でも本当に攻撃に使う魔法はゾルトラークでいいのですか？最も速射性に優れているからね。どうしてもその対処はたった一瞬、思考する分だけ遅れることになる。でもフェルンは違う。フェルンにとってゾルトラークは生まれた時からあった当たり前のもので。
An advantage of inexperience.
Yeah, and the spell is very special pretty much.
ありったけの魔力を叩き込むんだ。
Yeah, but you need to find the right timing for that. Oh? Okay.
フリーレン、お前は私のことが嫌いだろう。なぜ私の元に来た。
Oh.
A little more info on Sari.
先生の遺言状を届けに来た。悲しくないの？
気まぐれで育てた弟子だ。まるで報告書だな。
何が書いてあったの？
人間の文化圏では、今まで魔法は魔族の技術であるとして、表立った研究は、禁忌とされてきた。働きかけたのはフランメで、彼女は新設された宮廷魔法使いとやらの教育に携わっていた。
She made some changes.
She made basically a revolution.
For humans. 統一帝国の魔法の研究と軍事転用を始めるということだ。
That's dangerous.
わずか数十年で魔法は大陸中に普及する。人類の誰もが魔法を使える時代がやってくるんだ。
Yeah, that's scary.
But it's better than Demon King Crane.
そう、すごいことだね。
だが、それは私の望むところではない。こんな遺言は到底聞き入れられん。実に不愉快だ。
Fair enough.
誰もが魔法を使える時代だと。魔法は特別であるべきだ。
Only for privileged ones.
サイアル者以外に教えるつもりはない。こんなものをよこすとは。
先生はゼーリエは怒って遺言状を破り捨てるだろうって言っていたよ。
She knew.
じゃあ私は行くね。多分もう会うこともないと。
So that's the last time they ever met, 900 years ago.
They never liked each other.
その前に少し歩かないか。誰もが魔法を使える時代はフランメの夢だった。あの子のお気に入りの魔法を知っているか。花畑を出す魔法。何の役にも立たない。くだらない魔法だ。
She just appreciates the beauty. Nothing bad with that.
これはあの子が私よりもずっと背の小さな小娘だった頃に語った夢物語だ。あの子は私にとっては無にも等しいような短い人生で人類の魔法の階層にまで上り詰めた。
先生はいつも判断がとても早かった。まるで何かに急かされているみたいに。
She had very limited time comparing to these two.
重大な決断をしなければならない時がいくつもあるが、あの子たちはそれを先送りにはできないんだ。私たちの時間は永遠に近いのだから。
Actually, how long do they live in this world?
Super, super long, apparently.
たった千年だ。たった千年で人間の時代がやってくる。私たちは人間に追い抜かれる。
Will they?
Hater is always.
Aww.
鍛錬を怠るなよ、フリーレン。
Yeah, you have to keep up.
お前を殺す者がいるとすれば、それは魔王か。
Oh, humans?
人間の魔法使いだ。
Mm-hmm. Elves could be considered dangerous because they're living long.
楽しみだね、ゼリエ。
And now human is killing Feyran, literally, in front of her.
Wow.
Nice.
Feyran should be careful. Feyran apparently all this time was thinking in the background, what's the way to kill Feyran?
Out of jokes, when we first saw Feyran, we thought that, well, this girl is weird.She had some kind of like this cold vibe.
Yeah.
And she's very good in calculations, strategies. And that conversation with Sari about the human era, it will come right after the demon era. It happened.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sari's point is pretty clear that you will be killed either by Demon King or maybe one day some humans will decide that elves are too dangerous. And if every single human will have magic, they will be able to overpower elves.
Yeah.That's pretty smart. She totally should be careful who to trust. Feyran said to all this group, like, oh, you know, we'll figure it out. It was just me and Feyran. I think that's probably because so nobody will actually see her real weak spots and like the way she's fighting. So nobody will take an advantage of this information in the next round.
Feyran can be defeated. You just need to know her well.
Yeah, exactly. Well, anything, anybody can be defeated, but you just need to know the weak spots.Of this.
But on a contrast with Sari, Feyran is understanding humans very well.
Yeah, she can take humans seriously because for her it's something that today is alive, tomorrow is dead. So it makes a lot of sense.
Also find it a little funny that Sari is a right-winger who is just saying like, oh, magic, it's something special. Not everybody should be allowed to use magic. It's only for the talented ones, to the special ones. She does not approve that all humans should have magic. It's not for all of them. For her, magic is something sacred that she cherishes a lot. And seeing humans liking magic just because they can make flowers, like she just like, what? Really?
Yeah.
Is this your favorite spell?
That's true. Yeah, it was very visible that she find it like disgusting, weird. Like
yeah,
that.
She said it. Like I felt disgusted.
Yeah, which is terrible. But honestly, yeah, if everybody will have access to the magic, I feel like that's gonna be way higher level of the problems.Eventually, because like if everybody have the same skill, it will be way more complicated to, you know, like to fix some problems that will show up.
Thank you for watching this episode with us. Like this video if you like it, subscribe to our channel if you'd like to see our future reactions.
Leave a comment below what do you think about this episode, but no spoilers, and see you next one.
See ya.